Hey there, welcome to Project Kinisi. My name is Jonathan Tai, and I'm a robotics engineering senior at Worcester Polytechnic Institute. And Project Kinisi is my senior capstone. Over here at WPI, we like to call that an MQP. So what exactly am I doing for this MQP? Well, I'm taking this car behind me, right here, and I'm turning this into an autonomous vehicle. Now, what you're going to be seeing over this entire video series is going to be how we go from this hunk of metal into a hunk of metal that can drive itself. Of course, I'm not going to be the only person working on this. There is a whole team of people behind this project, making it successful. So, before I say anything else, let's have them introduce themselves as well as a bigger picture of what exactly this idea is.
My name is Cassie Pepicelli, and I'm a senior majoring in electrical computer engineering and minoring in business.
We are creating a modular system for autonomizing off-road vehicles while retaining full manual operability. We examine the current state of autonomous vehicles, and based off of that research, we're going to be designing and building our own prototype, and then later demonstrating modularity in other systems.
My name is Lan Hao Mao. I study robotics engineering at WPI. The team will use a previously student design and build SAE Baja vehicle. The Baja vehicle was built to compete in an off-road race. For this project, the team will outfit sensors and actuators to grant the car the ability to drive autonomously in an off-road environment.
My name is Sam White. I'm pursuing an MSPS in robotics engineering at Worcester Polytechnic Institute. For this project, I'm working on outfitting the vehicle with various actuators. It includes the steering and the braking of the car. For the braking, we're using a linear actuator, and for the steering, we're using a brushed DC motor. For the acceleration of the car, we're tapping into the existing throttle pedal. Now, it's important for the car to be able to actually send signals, whether that be starting and stopping or turning.
My name is Cooper Wolanin, and I'm a senior double major in robotics and electrical and computer engineering. So now that we've equipped the car with proper actuators in order to make it autonomous, it needs to be able to sense the outside world and make split-second decisions. So what we're doing is we're equipping it with several extraceptive sensors in order to take in the outside world and data fuse that information together in order to make it the proper decisions at the right times.
So my name is Gabriel Entov. I'm a double major in electrical and computer engineering and robotics engineering.
And what are you doing with this project?
So one thing Cooper mentioned is that this car needs to see its surroundings so it can decide what to do. And for that, we have a large range of sensors. We have a LiDAR in the front. It's 2D vision, so we won't tell what we're looking at, but we can see where it is. And that's for long range. And for shorter, we have a 3D camera where we can actually see what we're looking at. For geolocation, we have a GPS and an IMU. And the reason we have both is in the woods, a lot of the times your GPS will cut out, but we still need to get where we're going. On the sides, we're actually mounting ultrasonic sensors so that when we're turning, we know whether or not we should avoid that obstacle or drive away from it. And the reason they're on the sides is because that 2D LiDAR only has 180 degrees of view.
Hi, I'm Krysta Murdy. I am a senior at WPI. I am a double major with electrical and computer engineering and computer science.
I'll focus on mostly the programming aspects. So I'll be doing a lot of data fusion and a lot of decision making. So the data fusion will be taking a lot of information and data from the sensors around the vehicle and use that to get a general picture of the surroundings. And with that general picture, we're going to use decision making to figure out how the vehicle should move.
And I'm going to be working on the mechanical stuff as well as some of the software stuff as this project develops. So what can you expect from this video series? Well, quite frankly, we thought it'd be a good idea to log our progress this way, the challenges we face and how we overcome them, as well as the issues we run into. As well as, you know, this kind of might turn into a bit of a how to build your own autonomous car from scratch.
Assuming you got a car to work on, that is.
So expect a new update every other Saturday that kind of goes over what we've been up to over that 2 weeks. But also we'll probably be posting some behind the scenes stuff that you can find on our Facebook and our Instagram, so check those out while you're online. So, of course, a project of this size is going to be expensive, and we are looking for sponsorship in the form of funding or hardware that we use to outfit our vehicle for the project. But before I go any further, I want to say a huge thank you to Mitsubishi Electric Research Labs, as well as HiPAC for your generous donation to help us further our education. Now, if you're trying to get in touch with us, you can find us at kinisi@wpi.edu, or hit us up on our Facebook page. So, that's a basic overview of what this project is and what we're going to be doing with the car. This is episode zero, I guess, as an introduction, so stay tuned for episode one. Really excited to get started with this thing and share with you all the progress that we're gonna be making. Stay tuned.